So in the skeleton of cow, we are going to discuss about the scapula first, which is a triangular bone, okay, flat triangular bone as we can see here, and is situated craniolateral aspect of the thorax as you can see, and it is directed downward and forward and extend from third, fourth and fifth thoracic vertebrae upward direction, and distal end is up to the first, second and third rib, and it is possessing to each two surface, three angles and three borders. Lateral surface, this one is the lateral surface, which is divided into two unequal halves by a spine, and the spine is known as acromion process, that is scapular spine. This is the scapular spine, and this process, it is acromion process. This is the acromion process, as we can see. So this is the acromion process, and these unequal halves are named as supraspinous fossa and infraspinous fossa. Supraspinous and infraspinous fossa is having 1:3 ratio. Supraspinous fossa giving attachment to the supraspinatus muscle, and infraspinous fossa is giving attachment to the infraspinatus muscle. Okay, then we can see here, next thing is on the medial side. Suppose this is another one in which, if you are turning it in this position, you can see this is the medial surface. Medial surface is giving attachment to the subscapular muscle. So this is known as subscapular surface, like this, you can imagine. Lower or inferior aspect, this subscapular muscle is found. After that, we can see that angles. So first is the cranial angle, which is thin and formed by anterior and dorsal border. This is anterior border, this is dorsal border. This is the first angle, that is known as cranial angle. Then after that, this dorsal border here, you can see, give attachment to the scapular cartilage is found, that is half moon shaped structure, that is cartilaginous structure is found there. And then caudal angle is thick and formed by dorsal and posterior border. This is the caudal angle, this position, this is formed by dorsal and posterior border. This is posterior border. Okay, after that, the next thing is posterior border, which is thick and convex, and generally nutrient foramen is found here. In this position, you can see here, this is the nutrient foramen is visible. So nutrient foramen is found on the posterior border. Then distal angle comprises of glenoid cavity. This is the distal angle. If you see, if this is the accommodating the head of the humerus. So head of the humerus is found, and if you see here in another bone, this is the distal angle, which is comprising the glenoid cavity. So here, this is the glenoid cavity. Okay, this is the glenoid cavity, which is shallow articular area, which is shallow articular area for the accommodation of the head of the humerus. And rudimentary glenoid notch is found here. So this is the notch, as you can see, this is the glenoid notch. And after that, tuber scapulae. So in this position, this is the tuber scapulae. Tuber scapulae or supraglenoid tubercle is small, which is situated at cranial aspect of the glenoid cavity, and biceps brachii muscle is originate from this. And then a process is found, you can see here in this position, this is a process that is called coracoid process, which is a small projection from the medial aspect of the tuber scapulae, from which coracobrachialis muscle originate. Okay, so these are all the part here, you can see this is the medial surface. So three angles you have seen, two surface and three borders is we have seen. Okay, this is all about the scapula of cow.